Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we will discuss the necrosis. What is definition of the necrosis, types of necrosis, gross and microscopic morphology, and the next case. Now the definition of necrosis is death of cells and tissue in the living organism. Focal, multifocal necrosis terms are used. Are diffuse necrosis when necrosis affects a large area or entire tissue or organ. So 4 to 12 hours required for total loss of blood supply before then the microscopic changes are visible. Now by definition, points to remember are: necrosis is a type of cell death due to irreversible cellular injury. The cell death in living tissue or organism, release of cellular contents invites polymorphonuclear leukocytes, and it is always accompanied by inflammation. Common cause is ischemia. The live cells have nuclei with normal morphology. In necrosis, the dead cell may show pycnosis, condensation of the nuclei, karyorrhexis fragmentation, or karyolysis, disappearance of the nuclei. Nuclear changes are accompanied with cytoplasmic changes. Cytoplasm become more eosinophilic and become more opaque. Eosinophilia of the dying cell is due to the increased uptake of eosinophil stain, because for light microscopy eosin and hematoxylin stain are used. So we can say the necrosis is a irreversible cell injury leading to cell death, and it show nuclear and cytoplasmic changes. On morphological basis, we can classify different types of necrosis: coagulative necrosis, liquefactive necrosis, caseous necrosis, and fat necrosis. The most common is coagulative necrosis, and its cause is ischemia. Liquefactive necrosis and caseous necrosis, they all occur in different scenarios. Now in coagulative necrosis, the outline of the cells initially is maintained due to the denaturation of proteins. In liquefactive necrosis, there is loss of cellular detail. In caseous necrosis, there is coagulation as well as fragmentation. And in fat necrosis, there is saponification. So there is opaque appearance of the fat cells. Now one by one we take the types of necrosis. Coagulative necrosis, the commonest cause is ischemia. It occurs in solid organs like heart, spleen and kidney, and less often by other chemical agents. And there is ischemic, it is also called ischemic necrosis. Now the normal cardiac tissue at the left side and the damaged or necrosed on the right side, showing eosinophilia and inflammation. This is the splenic infarct and renal infarct. And renal tissue, if you see on microscopy, it will be ghosty appearance, then there will be inflammatory response, and then there is normal tissue. Now points of coagulative necrosis, points which are to be remembered. Coagulative necrosis, grossly it appears as pale yellow white area. It may be focal or diffuse, and microscopically outline is preserved initially. There is eosinophilia and inflammatory response. Now if there is ischemia of the extremity, sometimes it is called dry gangrene, and if it is superadded by bacteria, there is putrefaction, and it is called wet gangrene. Now in some clinicians use this term, otherwise it is a type of ischemic necrosis. Now gangrenous necrosis, the morphology is the same. Now the caseous, the ischemia caused in the liver, instead of coagulation there it caused liquefactive softening of the brain tissue, and when it leaving behind cavity, because there are hydrolytic enzyme in the neuron which cause softening. Points to remember are: the in the brain, the ischemia cause liquefactive necrosis and leaving behind a cavity which is at the site of the necrosis. And there is acellular material, cellular details is lost, homogeneous material surrounded by inflammation, and cause is ischemia. Brain has abundant lysozymal enzymes. Now the liquefactive necrosis can occur due to bacterial infection, entamoeba histolytica infection. You can see the pus filled cavity in the liver, and chocolate brown sauce like fluid is obtained, and microscopically it is central pus surrounded by inflammation. So microscopically the points to remember are, grossly there is pus filled cavity, and there is maybe drainage of the brown, chocolate brown material in the test tube and leaving behind the raw surface. Microscopically, necrotic debris surrounded by inflammation. Cause is pus forming bacteria and entamoeba histolytica, because proteolytic enzyme are secreted by the leukocytes and also from the damaged cells. Now the caseous necrosis. Caseous necrosis is descriptive term because it is a cheese-like material, friable, soft, and grossly, and it is caused by mycobacterium tuberculosis infection. And microscopically, there is caseous necrosis, a cellular necrotic material in the center surrounded by granulomatous inflammation. Granuloma is composed of epitheloid cell, giant cells, and surrounded by a collar of lymphocytes. Now in caseous necrosis, points to remember are, grossly it is yellow white, soft, friable, cheesy material, and microscopically there is caseous necrosis, amorphous granular debris in the center, and then surrounded by granulomatous inflammation. In this microscopic view, you can appreciate the caseous necrosis, multinucleated giant cell, epitheloid cell, and surrounded by lymphocyte. So granuloma is a descriptive term of caseous necrosis, central caseation necrosis, epitheloid cell, Langhans giant cells, and collar of lymphocytes. Now the another type is fat necrosis. Fat necrosis may be enzymatic, cause or trauma. Enzymatic digestion of the fat occur in the acute pancreatitis. Outer surface of the pancreas show chalky white areas which are firm in consistency. And microscopically there is hazy appearance of the fat cells. Now trauma can cause fat necrosis in the breast. This is the breast specimen. You can see irregular white areas. These are due to the trauma, lead to non-enzymatic fat necrosis. Normally, if we see the fat tissue under the microscope, it consists of clear cells and a rim of a cytoplasm with containing nuclei. And when fat necrosis, there is bluish pink appearance of the fat cells. So points to remember are, in fat necrosis, fat necrosis can occur in enzymatic digestion or traumatic, and there is chalky white areas on the pancreas. They are firm in consistency. And microscopically there is loss of clear cytoplasm of fat cell, cloudy appearance of fat cell, loss of nuclei surrounded by inflammatory reaction, and cause is pancreatitis, inflammation of pancreas, and in the breast it is trauma. Now there is another type of necrosis which is called fibrinoid necrosis. It occurs usually in the vessel wall, and there is exudation of pink fibrinoid material in the vessel wall. There is narrowing of the lumen, and it is surrounded by leukocyte. Here you can appreciate narrowing of the lumen due to thickening of the wall. There is exudation of the pink material, and there is surrounded by leukocytes. Now points to remember in fibrinoid necrosis are, it is immune mediated, usually seen in the vessel wall. There is narrowing of the lumen and surrounded by inflammation. So we should always recite this dua, that we can Allah protect us from all these diseases. Now next case will be of coagulative necrosis with case scenario. This video is presented to you by Pakistan Homeschool, and you can go to YouTube channel and watch other videos as well.